So we've talked about adding vectors. Now we have to need to discuss how do you multiply vectors. There are two types of ways of multiplying vectors. The first one I want to talk about is called the dot product. Sometimes it's called the scalar product. And that's because the multiplication of two vectors results in a scalar. So let's look at the vectors. Say A, we're going to write in component form, is A1i plus A2j plus A3k. And B, the same form, B1i plus B2j plus B3k. So the dot product then is written as A dot B is a scalar product, so the result is a scalar. And quite simple, you multiply the components A1, B1, and A2, B2, and A3, B3, and then add them. So A1, B1 plus A2, B2 plus A3, B3. Okay, and that's a scalar now, right? Because there's no vector here on the right-hand side. So what is the algebra of this dot product? It's easy to see that multiplication commutes. So A dot B is equal to B dot A. And it's easy to see that multiplication distributes over addition. So A dot B plus C is equal to A dot B plus A dot C. And then when you multiply a vector by a constant, one can also see that A dot A constant, let me call the constant D, say, A dot D times B equals D times A dot B is equal to D times A dot B. Okay? So that's the definition of the dot product, and we see its algebra. There's another way of defining the dot product that's a little bit more geometrically. So if we look at two vectors, so here's one vector, and here's a second vector. Okay, so let's say this vector is A and this vector is B. We can define a coordinate system to compute the dot product. So you're given vectors and you're free to choose any coordinate system you want. So let's choose the coordinate system that is where the x-axis is just along the A vector. And then the y-axis is perpendicular, okay? We choose this coordinate system, and then we can try to compute A dot B. So we have these components. So what are the vectors in terms of the components? Well, A vector, right, is along the x-axis, and it has a magnitude of A. So this is the length of A, and it's along the x-axis. So we have the I vector, okay? What about B, right? So we can find the two components of B. We can drop here. We can use some trigonometry here. So this is an angle theta. So the base here is the length of the hypotenuse times the cosine of the angle. And the height here is the length of the hypotenuse times the sine of the angle. So B is equal to the length of B times cosine theta times I plus the length of B times sine theta times J. Okay? So by having two vectors, two arbitrary vectors, we can impose a coordinate system where x-axis is along one of the vectors and the vectors lie in the xy plane. Then we get this component forms of A and B, and we can compute A dot B. So then A dot B is just the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times cosine theta. Right, plus the zero times B sine theta, because the J component here is zero. The Y component is zero for A. So this is the dot product of A and B. And you see that this is independent of coordinate system. So this is true in any coordinate system. A dot B is equal to the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of the angle between them. Okay, there's two points I would like to make here. What happens if A and B are parallel? So if A is parallel to B, right, that means that B is a scalar constant times A. If A and B are parallel, B is a constant times A. Then A dot B is going to be the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B, right? The angle here is zero and cosine theta, cosine of zero is one. What if A is perpendicular to B? Then theta is pi over 2, and cosine of pi over 2 is 0. So that means for two perpendicular vectors, A dot B is equal to 0. OK, let me review. I'm introducing what's called the scalar product. Most frequently, it's called the dot product. It takes two vectors, A and B, and we write A dot B. We say A dot B, and that is just the product of the components summed over all components. So three terms in the dot product. It's a scalar. There is no vectors on the right-hand side. From this definition, the dot product is commutative. It's a distributive over addition, and a scalar can be multiplied against any vector. Doesn't matter. Finally, we can have a geometric definition of the dot product. A dot B is the length of the vector A times the length of the vector B times the cosine of the angle between them. What that means is that if A is parallel to B, meaning that A is equal to a scalar times B, then A dot B is just the length of A times the length of B. And if A is perpendicular to B, then A dot B equals 0. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.